Okay, now, in this video, I'll be comparing a bagging lawnmower blade versus a mulching blade. And let me clarify that the comparison points and comments here are only my points of view of these two different blade types for your reference only. As you know, lawnmower blades are defined in two main categories, which are bagging blades and mulching blades. As their name indicates, bagging blades are shaped in a way that helps push the grass clips inside the bag as the grass is being cut. On the other hand, mulching blades have small notches on their ends, which helps on cutting the clippings multiple times and return them back to your lawn in a wave of nutrients. This video has been filmed on springtime. We have rained a few days ago and the grass is wet. I have tall fescue grass on my backyard, and the size of this backyard is about 1500 square feet. Here, I'm using the mulching blade, which came with the lawnmower when I bought it. Right at this moment, the mower engine starts to struggle. This is because the wet grass gets stuck on the sides of the deck and it starts to impede the blade rotation. From time to time, I need to raise the front side of the mower so some of the clippings can get detached and allow the blade to keep on going. But this is only a momentary fix, since the lawnmower will stop at the point, and the mulch clips will be left all over the place. As you can see, not many of the clippings get sent to the back, since this is a mulching blade design. When the mower stops, I need to clean the underside of the deck in order to keep on cutting the lawn. I usually need to do this about 3 times when I'm cutting the backyard at this time of the year. Okay, now it's time to switch to the bagger blade and see how things will perform. I got this bagging blade at Amazon, which fits my Toro 22-inch lawnmower. I will leave the link for this blade on the video description box in case you want to try it out. The blade is painted on all of its surfaces. The paint needs to be removed on the cutting area before it can be used. The mower did not stop at any time while cutting my backyard with this blade. And look at this bag. We have a complete load of clippings thanks to the bagging blade. Let's take a look at the deck now. And it looks pretty good after cutting this damp grass. These are my final thoughts on these blades. A bagging blade will provide you with a better performance by sending more clips to the bag and hence extending the lifetime of your lawnmower. By not putting as much stress with mulching clippings, especially when the grass is wet, it would also give you a better cleaner deck after mower. The benefit I see of a mulching blade is that it returns some of the clips back to your soil in a form of nutrients, but this will leave the cuttings on top of your fresh cut lawn. I personally prefer to have all clippings back and compensate the nutrients with a fertilizer application. But at the end, it's up to you to what blade type to use. Don't forget to check the blade link. I will leave the link on the description box if you decide to give it a try. This is all for today, and until next time, please like, share, and subscribe if you found this video helpful. For more tutorials, how-to, and product videos, visit handynoah.com.